Imperial Tobacco focuses in duty-free and travel retail, especially on shopper behavior. So we want to find out, like, how can we cluster shopper behavior? How can we make it meta and more interesting to see, like, well, actually, I'm German, but maybe I behave in travel retail duty-free in my shopping behavior like a Russian or like an Indian. So yes, clustering in terms of nationalities is always a little bit delicate because you play with stereotypes. So cliches is not what we want to do, but it's really about strategy, insights, amazing, a lot of statistics that we have to analyze and look into, crazy Excel files and sheets. But when you break that down, so the whole complexity reduced, it is about the nationality focus. And then we have to look into habits, and what habits actually do we have? Does our shopper have? So habits like, do they buy luxury goods? Do they buy maybe different kinds of category? Do they focus on one single category? So what does actually the shopping basket look like? And this is science, I can tell you, real science. And we try to make it fun. We try to make it a concept that everybody understands and buys into. So we hope that this is interesting for the shop concepts, for the concessionaires, for the retailers, for the airports to understand, and for our business partners, of course. We are convinced that tobacco regulation that hits tobacco will hit the other categories as well, because we have cases where we can prove. So unfortunately, we have cases like Ireland when they turned into the display ban and so on, so that we saw what an impact it had on the total sales. So tobacco sales went down like about 30%, but the total impact was, I think, more than 10%. But it's not only about statistics. It's also when you look into the full concept of duty-free and travel retail, it is about freedom. It is about the freedom of traveling, the free movement of goods, and so on and so on. So how in a restricted area, if you have tighter regulation going on, and then you try to promote that you are an open country welcoming tourists, I mean, you can really offend tourists who have a language barrier and who might feel ashamed about asking for their tobacco brand. So Imperial Tobacco is opposed against what we call denormalization, so really like discriminating the smoker, discriminating the traveler, and putting him under pressure. Because duty-free and travel retail is a highly restricted area already. I mean, what other shopping environment you have to take your belt off and almost have to undress yourself to get into the shop, and then even if you buy chewing gum, you have to show your boarding pass. So there is no exposure to young people and so on and so on. So I think this thinking is important, this knowledge is important, and especially when I think about our colleagues in alcohol, they are facing challenges now as well. So we see the spillover effect. So tobacco, yes, strict regulation in many countries, but now they look into alcohol and even into confectionery when it comes to that they have to comply to national labeling. So it's, I looked at a presentation from Mondelez, and I thought, like, ooh, this could be our PowerPoint slides, because they have exactly the same issues in terms of labeling. They cannot comply with each and every national law in the world, because then duty-free would not exist as a product range anymore.